Good morning, students. This is Mrs. Olive Caleb. I welcome you back to the new session of English language. Once again, I shall take you through a very simple topic, tenses, and at the same time, very important as well. Well, most students get tensed when we talk about tenses, but there is nothing really to get tensed about, because today we are going to simplify tenses. Well, tenses is nothing but the ability of verbs to situate themselves in time. So, we have verbs and then we have time. So, to understand tenses, let us understand a verb first. A verb means ash. A stands for action, S for state of being, and H for having. Action words are the main verbs, like you must have heard sleep, drive, write, play. These are the action words, or you can say main verbs. Second one, state of being, that stands for helping verbs, that is, am, are, was, were, and will be. And having is for has, have, and had. So a verb means ash. A for action, that is action verbs, or you can say the main verbs. S stands for state of being, that is helping verb. Is, am, are, was, were, and will be. And H for having, that is has, have, and had. Later on, these verbs are divided into two, finite verb and non-finite verb. A finite verb has a subject and a tense, and non-finite verbs, they do not have subjects and no tense. What is the meaning of the subject? We have already done in the previous chapter, a subject is a noun or pronoun before a verb. Let us understand this with the example. She has not yet arrived. I've already told you finite verbs are the verbs which has subject and tense. She, I told you, a subject is a noun or a pronoun used before a verb, or you can say a person we speak about. She is a subject and has arrived is a verb, and this is present perfect tense. So this sentence has a subject and a tense, so it is a finite verb. Now we come to non-finite verb. Let us look at the example. While swimming, he broke his foot. Now we all know that there are two verbs in the sentence, swimming and broke. There is a word before swimming, while. Do you think while is a subject? No. Remember the definition of a subject, a noun or a pronoun before the verb. The verb which cannot be a noun and it is not a pronoun, hence this is not a subject. The verb swimming does not have a tense. You might think it has a tense and it is a continuous tense. Well, I shall agree with you. But tell me, which type of continuous tense is this? Is it present, past or future? I'm sure you must have got confused. This word swimming is only ing verb and does not have tense, because we do not have any verb or helping verb before this. That indicates whether the action is in the present or was in the past or is future. The word swimming is a non-finite verb since it does not have any helping verb before it. The second verb is broke. The verb broke has a word he before it. And we all know that word he is a pronoun. It is a pronoun before a verb, that means we have a subject. And broke is a simple past tense. And it is a finite verb since it has a subject. Let us take a look at the different verbs forms. There are three forms of the verb: present, past and past participle. Let us take an example of the verb eat. It is the base form of the verb, which is also known as V1, whereas ate is the past form of the verb and eaten is the third form, that is past participle form of the verb, which is also known as V3. Present V1, past V2, and past participle, the third form of the verb, you can write V3. The base form is eat, the past of eat is ate, and the past participle form of eat is eaten. Same with drive, drove, driven, hurt, heard, hurt. All the three forms of hurt are same. There is no such word hurted and hitted. We write hurt, and the past tense of hurt is hurt, and the past participle, that is third form of the verb, is also hurt. Same with hit. The base form of hit is hit, the past form of hit is also hit, and the third past participle form of hit is also hit. So tenses are nothing. Tense is actually a word which means time, and time is divided into three: present, past and future. The tenses are further divided into four forms as well. First is simple tense, second is continuous tense, third is perfect tense, and the fourth is perfect continuous tense.